Netcasts you love.
From people you trust.
This is Twit.
Bandwidth for iOS Today is provided by CacheFly at CacheFly.com.
The iPhone 7 is here, love it or leave it. And Leo, it is never too early for you to start learning shapes and other things that people learn in kindergarten.
Now, on iOS Today.
iOS Today is brought to you by Wealthfront. Wealthfront is a low-cost automated investment service and the most sophisticated way to invest your money. Whether you've got millions or you're just starting out, visit Wealthfront.com/iOS today and sign up to get your free personalized investment portfolio. That's Wealthfront.com/iOS today. And by Audible.com. To download the free audiobook of your choice, go to Audible.com/iOS today. And by Blue Apron. Blue Apron will send you fresh, high-quality ingredients to cook delicious meals with simple, step-by-step instructions right to your door. See what's on the menu this week and get your first three meals free with free shipping by going to blueapron.com/twit. I love these Bluetooth headphones.
They just work, right?
No, they're actually... Here's the irony. I can't... These are Beats. These are the original Beats. Well, Beats 2 solos. Bluetooth headphones. I bought them because I wanted to find out what's going on. And by the way, because the NFL doesn't allow me to wear Beats headphones, I had to tape over the B, just so you know. They work when you... Once they're paired, but ironically, I'm having a hard time getting them paired right now.
Yeah.
Bluetooth.
Yeah.
It's not just for audio anymore.
It's sort of frustrating. We're going to talk about a lot of the things that we will need in the future, including...
Headphone jacks.
Headphones. Or, you know, or new headphones with lightning connectors, of course.
This is, as you know, our first iOS Today after the Apple announcement.
Yep.
So we're still reeling.
I'm reeling. and busy ordering lots of stuff.
What'd you order? What'd you get?
Well, okay. So I ordered the matte black. I did not. I took a Twitter poll.
You let Twitter choose your phone?
But I put matte black first. And that is sort of a lead-in, you know, and
because
that's what I wanted. Because I don't want the jet black. Unless I'm on the show, I don't use a case. And so I barely got to show off Rose Gold, or Rosie, as I called her, or Big Rose. Sometimes I call her that, too. So I think matte black is good enough. But then you ordered an extra that you're taking on vacation with
you.
So
this is complicated.
I might get that one.
You could have that one. Mm-hmm. So here's the deal. Did you get up at midnight to do this?
No, John was going to get up at midnight, but he got up, but he forgot to ask me what carrier I have.
He didn't know what to do.
And then I realized John doesn't know me at all because most people know
Sprint.
I'm Sprint. I'm cheap. I don't like change and things. You know, I'm loyal.
Because I did get up at midnight and I was up with the chat room, as you know, chat room, and some of them were ordering and I was watching others like iJustine, and universally everybody was complaining that you couldn't get the Sprint phone. The Sprint site was bogged down, and if you tried to order through Apple, the way Apple does these things, if you're ordering a phone through a carrier, even if you're buying it from Apple, they connect with the carrier, and if the carrier is not responding, they can't do anything. So I'm a T-Mobile guy, but I really want an unlocked phone. I mean, that's usually what I want. But the T-Mobile phone is unlocked. Although we'll give you a little tip a little later on. There's maybe a better phone than the T-Mobile phone if you want an unlocked phone. But I got on the Apple site midnight, refresh, refresh, refresh. I'm smart too, though, because I've noticed this in the past. I've done this a few times that the Apple Store app sometimes goes live before the website goes live. So I also have my iPad and I'm refreshing the Apple Store at midnight. Because my goal really is to have the new phone next Friday so that I can talk about it on the radio show so that you can have it for iOS Today. We want to get it as soon as possible since we don't get review units. 12:08, website's still down. Suddenly I'm on. I'm on the App Store on the iPad. Excitement. I go to Jet Black. Immediately, I go to Jet. It says, which phone do you want? 7 Plus. What color do you want? Jet Black. What size do you want? 128 gigabytes. Buy. And then I see it says, delivers October 16th or something like that, October 4th. And I went, wait, how could you sold out of all the Jet Blacks in 5 seconds? So I'm wondering how many they had. Did anybody, did you get a Jet Black in the first few seconds? Or did they really just not have any at all? So I ordered it for October 4th, but we still have this problem. I still need a phone for the show.
Mm-hmm. So
I went to AT&T and ordered it. And they should have done what Sprint did. Maybe they did. I don't know. But Sprint should have done what AT&T did. The Apple server said, "Well, we can't reach AT&T right now, but we're gonna put you in line to get a phone." And I had to go to the gold 128 gig. I couldn't get a black, Jet Black, or matte black. I couldn't get a rose gold even in the time frame. But September 16th, this Friday, I should have a 128 gigabyte gold 7 Plus. So we will have that in-house. We'll do an unboxing on Friday. I'll do it on TNT if you want.
Yeah, that would be great. So, you know, the secret is when I got the 6S, I just walked into a store, and not even like first thing in the morning in the store.
You didn't wait in line? You just walked in?
No, I walked in the late in the afternoon because they get shipments throughout the day.
Ah.
And so I walked in because I wanted the rose gold. That was the first, you know, time we had rose gold in an iPhone. And they were like, "Oh, you're in luck. We just got a shipment in. Come on." And they sold it to me.
And you could cancel the online order.
Yes, I canceled
it.
And so that's
We might do that again on Friday. Mm-hmm. I'll be very curious if they'll have Jet Black, though. I'm feeling like, you know, that first of all, the newest color, whether it's rose gold last year, gold the year before that, or Jet Black this year, is always the one that's in the most demand. And this year, especially because the 128 and 256 gig configurations, if you want the big ones, you got to get the Jet Black.
Mm-hmm.
I'm wondering if the new materials technology they're using to create that Jet Black finish. You saw Johnny Ive go on and on about the buffing and the thingamin and then the sandbox they run it through and all that. If maybe they just, there aren't, it takes them a long time to make them.
Maybe
they're in short supply. Maybe there was an issue. The other thing with Jet Black is, and you saw this, and I think this is why you wanted to go with the matte black, is it may scratch, right? It said even on the website, may suffer fine scratches. We recommend you use a case.
And then what's the point of what color?
I could have a gold phone in that case,
yeah.
Right?
Even the see-through plate cases. I don't really like
that. Well, I've ordered, and I was hoping this box, but it wasn't. It was cookies. Isn't that disappointing? I hate it when I get cookies in the mail. But I was hoping it was the, because I ordered the cheap Ringkey case that's just kind of rubbery plastic that's clear. And I learned that lesson, and they have that available, and that should come in the next day or two. I learned that lesson because of the scratches I had on other phones waiting for an official, you know, well, we got the phone, now we're going to be, you know, people like OtterBox, they're so careful. They want to actually try their case in a phone before they sell it. So those are delayed a little longer. They'll come after the phone comes out. But this Ringkey case, because it's kind of stretchy and rubbery, I think they don't care. So I'm going to have that. But I think... I want to bring this phone on my trip.
Yeah, you can bring it on your trip.
Because I want to use the camera.
And I'll get the matte black.
The only thing that's really different in these phones, there's not that much difference. In fact, there's really only 1, 2, 3, 4 differences. Well, there's 5. And okay, there's 6. But anyway, there's only 8 differences. But the biggest difference is the 2 camera lenses on the iPhone 7 Plus. And so I'm really interested in trying that out.
Yeah.
And I'm going to have some opportunities to take pictures.
And so those of you who have the iPhone Forever plan, the turn it in every year, we sent our intrepid reporter, Brian Oleski, my dad, to...
How did that go? So he's paying the $32 a month to get a new phone every year.
So they made him get a certain size. He turned in his 6S Plus.
So did he have to get another 6S Plus?
No,
7S Plus.
Yes, he had to get another, and he had to get the, I guess, 150 or...
Oh, he had to get exactly the same size and the same model. Could he get his own color?
He got
color.
Jet black.
Oh, good.
He ordered jet black, and it's coming, he said, beginning of October, October 7th. And they made him pay $100.
What?
Down payment.
Oh, but he'll get that refunded?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, so that, you know, if you are not familiar with that plan, it's 24 payments, and then after 12 payments, then you can turn it in for another one. So he's I guess, paid 12 payments and then gotten a new phone.
You know, I did the math, and I can't remember what it was, but it was about 2/3 of the cost of the phone. So it is more expensive if you keep a phone for 2 years. You'd be paying more for that phone. There's also the risk of losing it or damaging it, right? I think you'd be on the hook if you lost it.
Yeah.
So I just buy them. I think we buy them outright. It seems like the sensible thing to do.
Yeah.
And then, so you're going to get your matte black when?
October 7th is my ship date, too. But I think I'm going to just walk in the store. Maybe perhaps John would like to go to a store. He likes the Apple store.
Yeah. John, you want to go? And because we have you know the manager there or something, right? We have friends there or something.
Plus, he needs a new iPhone, too.
You have strings you can pull there?
Sometimes.
If I should go with you. I'm not doing anything on Friday. Maybe I'll come. We'll go. Are you going to wait in line?
Mm.
We've done that before. There shouldn't be a line this year. Maybe there is.
You should go.
So here's what's different.
Time for you guys.
Here's the 22 different things.
Okay.
Now, the ones that leap to mind, of course, are this two camera lenses. One is 28 millimeter. That's the one that you have, we have, we all have right now. Somewhat wide angle. Nice. That's pretty typical on a camera phone. And then they're calling it 2X zoom, but it's actually effectively 56 millimeters, which isn't traditionally a zoom lens. If you're a photographer, you know that that's kind of a normal lens. That's roughly what the eye sees. But since the lens on a camera phone is wide, when you go to the normal size, it feels like you are, in fact, zooming in two times. So there's a button, and you could switch back and forth. The thing I'm more, and we've seen that before, by the way, the LG G5 does that. Exactly that. Two lenses, two different settings. But I'm interested in how Apple does the zoom in between the two lenses, because theoretically that could be better than just a pure optical zoom. They can maybe mix images from the two lenses, maybe get a better zoom. So we'll be looking at that.
Mm-hmm.
And then next month they're going to come out with this fake bokeh thing where you get the blurry background, the portrait thing. We call it Foca.
Mm.
And the Foca will be available next month, so we won't be able to test that. The other things that are new, you're going to have stereo speakers. That's nice. The home button doesn't move anymore.
Mm-hmm.
It's a solid button, just like on the MacBook, but they're using haptic feedback to simulate a click. I'm skeptical of that, and I've talked to a number of people who like it, and some people who didn't, people tried it at the demo room, who said, it's not great. The whole bottom of the phone buzzes. So I want to see how that
is. So we should say about the camera, that fancy camera you described at first is just for the Plus, just for
That's
the bigger
right.
version.
That's right.
But the smaller version, just the 7, also gets an upgrade in the camera.
12 megapixel, 28 millimeters. What does it get? Like 6 elements, 5 elements.
I guess. And it has optical stabilization.
That's huge. And they say that's before. Because... The other feature, they took out the headphone jack. Mm-hmm. That's the most controversial feature. That gave them a lot more room in the case to do stereo speakers, to do the haptic feedback, and to give you optic image stabilization in both the 7 and the 7 Plus this year. The other new things, the A10 processor is a lot faster. If you have an iPhone 6, it's, Apple says, 60% faster. That is a huge jump in 2 years. And I think of all the things Apple's really leading the pack in, it's that. Their processor technology, because they have 1,000 chip engineers, even though it's a licensed architecture from ARM, they really customize it. They're doing the best, easily the best chips in any phone, smartphone out there. Much better than the Qualcomm chips everybody else uses in the U.S. So that is an advantage. That's a strong advantage. And, of course, they showed off gaming and how well that works. The graphics will also be equally faster. That's a big difference. I don't feel like my phone is slow. I always say this every year. Do you?
I don't feel like it's slow, but the battery is definitely not as good as it was. It doesn't last as long.
So the new phone, this is another thing because they took out the headphone jack, more room, 14% bigger battery. That means 2 hours improvement on the iPhone 7 over the iPhone 6S and an hour improvement over the already very good iPhone 6S Plus. Mm-hmm. It's going to be an hour longer on the 7 Plus. So, I mean, that's good. Apple really has battery life down, I think. There's more RAM in the phone. That should also help with speed up. And there are a lot of other features. But to me, it's going to look very similar. You know, is it a feature that the antenna lines are moving from the kind of visible antenna lines on the back of the phone? They're going to move up to these up here.
I like that. I think those are kind of ugly.
Yeah, they're ugly. Yeah.
But again, it'll be you have a case on it.
A full metal case. There are a few other differences
four
like that.
Four speakers.
Is it four or just two?
Two.
It's going to be stereo.
Stereo speakers.
Yeah.
Four speakers on the iPad, two speakers
on
the iPhone.
But even the iPad doesn't use all four at any one time. They just use it because when you rotate it, they can move the speakers around. But I hear it's a lot louder. Again, we haven't heard it because we weren't at the demo right after the keynote on Wednesday. But I hear. But David Pogue and others have told us it was a lot louder, and the sound's pretty good. Who listens to open speakers for their sound, though? Really? Do you? The biggest thing, we might as well get into that, is they're taking out the headphone jack. Now, you've heard all the benefits, but the disadvantages are also obvious. Mm-hmm. You can't charge and listen at the same time without an additional dongle. Apple doesn't sell one. Belkin is for $40. It's ugly. It's big. if your car has an aux jack, but not a lightning port, you'll no longer be able to use that auxiliary jack to listen to your music. Some people are not going to like that. If you spend a lot of money on headphones, you're going to have to get an adapter. Now, the good news is Apple's going to bundle lightning, wired lightning headphones in the box and the headphone adapter that takes a regular headphone jack and adapts it for the new lightning port. And those are only $9. And that was a real relief to me. In the past, Apple's charged a lot for connectors like this, $30 for the old 30-pin to lightning connector. $9 means, and you should probably prepare for this, buy 5 or 10. You know, add an extra $45 to $90 to your budget and buy a bunch of these. And if you connect them to all the headphones, then your headphones are lightning ready. But ultimately, Apple's plan, it's very clear, is to get rid of wires entirely. Maybe even, I don't know, do wireless. Next year, it's possible with the iPhone Anniversary Edition, wireless charging.
Next year?
Possibly.
I know, because we've argued about that before, because I think it's on the horizon. But you said you don't know how they would do it.
Well, they can't do an aluminum phone with wireless charging, so they'll have to go back to the glass back or something else. But everybody's been saying, well, the 10th anniversary iPhone is going to be a massive redesign. I'm not sure that's a good idea, because frankly, this is about perfect. You know, you could make, I guess, smaller bezels or something. I don't know. I don't know what you would do to make this phone so much better for the 10th anniversary. But one thing people are mentioning is, well, if we put wireless charging in and these AirPods take off and people start using Bluetooth, who needs a lightning port? You don't need any connectors at all. And obviously, that's something Apple would like. Mm-hmm. They would love a phone with no holes on it. By the way, losing the headphone jack might help with the waterproof. This is now an IPX67 waterproof phone. It can spend half an hour underwater up to 10 meters.
Really? Half an hour?
I thought it was
just water resistant.
They don't want to emphasize that because I think they don't want people experimenting. Yeah. Just as this phone is probably somewhat waterproof, the current generation, they never mentioned that. This is technically IPX67, which I think it's 67, or is that the watch? Anyway, it's according to David Pogue. It's a 6.7. It is. Okay.
But the resistant is the word they use. So, like,
But that means if you look up that standard.
That's 30 minutes.
30 minutes at 10 meters.
So don't shower with it, though.
No, you could.
But you don't need to.
You could. One meter. I'm sorry. Is it 1 meter? All right. Sorry.
If it falls in the pool, grab it, hold it over your head, and swim to the side. Don't swim like that.
Don't intentionally do it. That's why they're saying water resistant. Yeah. But that's actually really good. Mm-hmm. And not having a big hole for the headphone, that helps, right? You don't have to seal that off.
So do you charge and listen a lot?
I don't, but I can see scenarios where you would.
The plane. An airplane.
Airplane. Actually, I have done that in the airplane. At night, you want to charge your phone, but you want to listen to music at night. At work, you want to keep your phone charged, but you want to listen at work.
Work, you also have a computer where you could listen to music on that, right?
Maybe. I don't know. What do you
work?
I don't
know. Okay, if you're not working with computers, I got it.
You might not.
Okay, got it.
In your car, when you're driving around, usually I keep it on the charger, and if you're not using Bluetooth, most people are going to use Bluetooth. I think Apple's plan is just, let's all go wireless.
Yeah.
So one of the things I did, do not attempt to charge a wet phone. Thank you very much, Kevin. Good advice.
Yeah.
So I was in the T-Mobile store returning my Note 7.
Yeah, don't charge that
exploding phone.
Don't charge that whether it's wet or dry.
Talk about a windfall for Apple. Mm-hmm. Now you have 1.5 million disaffected Samsung customers who are afraid or don't even just want to wait till an updated Note 7 comes out. And lo and behold, they have $850 in their pocket and no phone. And why? There's an iPhone 7. So anyway, while I was in there, they were doing $100 off the Beats Solo 2, which is the previous generation of Bluetooth. Apple announced the Beats Solo 3 with the W1 chip in it. This does not have the Apple Bluetooth chip that they made, the W1 chip. So I'm going to take my iPad out of my lovely case. We'll talk about that in a little bit.
I have some Bluetooth headphones also that I will like to show off after you show yours off.
Should we do that now?
Yeah.
Okay. I also ordered an Apple Watch.
I know.
Did you?
I didn't.
You're happy with yours.
No, I'm not happy with mine. I was just waiting for someone else to offer to pay for it.
You're waiting for Uncle Leo to say. It's not much change. It's twice as fast, right? It is now waterproof, which means you can swim with it, so swimmers will be thrilled. Mm-hmm. And I love this. The speaker, when you're swimming and it gets water in it, then you get out of the pool, spits the water out. How many watches do that?
I know, that's awesome.
Does it, I hope it makes a sound like...
Yeah, Conky says you should give me the ceramic watch you ordered. I already suggest that, Tim. I'm way ahead of you, Conky.
I ordered the ceramic. So Apple, without any fanfare, they didn't mention this, has discontinued the $10,000 gold Apple Watch. Mm-hmm. I hope, at the very least, they offer an upgrade to people who spent that much money on a watch. They said, you know, we could put the Series 2 guts in there. We'll just squish them a little bit and put them in there or something.
Maybe no one bought it.
Maybe that was the problem. No, I know people who bought it. People definitely bought it. I don't know anybody who bought it, come to think of it. But I know I've seen celebrities.
Right.
They probably got it for free, but I've seen
them all away.
Yeah. Pharrell wasn't wearing his, you know. Oh. Maybe you should ask Pharrell if he's going to could give you his
watch.
I
will do that.
So the new edition, which is the expensive one, is this white ceramic. Not just white. No other color. That surprised me, too. I've had ceramic watches, black ceramic watches, which I've loved. Ceramic is a very interesting material. Modern ceramics are harder than steel. They don't scratch. Mm-hmm. They're really, really tough. And they look beautiful because they maintain a high gloss. And, you know, white's interesting. You really can't do white well in plastic. So doing it in ceramic means they can do a nice pearl white finish on that watch. But I thought they would offer black. I bet you they will. At some point, offer also a black ceramic watch to match your jet black phone. Maybe they'll make a ceramic, ceramic anniversary phone that you could charge through.
Yeah.
That you could charge through. So maybe that's what the jet black will be. Anyway, so I did order that watch. And that will come while I'm gone. So if you notice a long box from Apple, they say AI on the return address. So if you see something from AI that comes to the studio,
we'll open it up.
You may
try it. And if it's really not that breakable, then who knows?
Hit it with a hammer and see.
Okay. I'm not going to do
that. And then I'll be back October 5th. We'll have it that week to show it off.
If I break it, I'll just get out my pottery wheel and make you another one.
Yeah. Well, I thought it would be less like clay. This is kind of like, I remember like my kids making things like this for me in preschool. So, people are probably saying, oh, Leah, why did you buy a $1,300 Apple Watch? And especially since you don't even like the Apple Watch.
For you. He did it for you.
I did it for you. For some reason, I ordered a jet black phone because we need to review the new finishes, the new looks. You want to see it, probably. People want to see it. So, and I do like ceramic as a watch material. It's very light, very strong. So, you know, and then I'll hand it down as I do with everything, and mm-hmm. you'll get it. But so we were going to show you, these are the Solos. Beats headphones are not audiophile headphones, but they do appeal to people who like a strong bass. It's great for listening to music, dance music, hip hop. And I think so that means with young people, they're fairly popular and they've got that Beats styling. Remember, Apple makes these. So if you were a cynic, you might say, oh, this is all, you know, a plan to boost Beats revenue by making a Bluetooth headset kind of a requirement for the new iPhone. So the problem with the current system is I've got these headphones. I'd already paired them, in the past. I've paired them to this, iPad. So you can see it sees it. It says my devices. Do you have a shot of my iPad? So let's see here. Let's get this all out of the way. So you can see it says Beats Solo Wireless, not connected. And this is why, by the way, everybody says, oh, I don't want Bluetooth headphones. So these are turned on, right? See the light? Let's connect the Beats Solo Wireless. Da 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 da. Da, 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 da. I'm not going to go on. This will go on for a minute or two. And if it's true to form, as it was before the show, it won't pair. Once it pairs, connection unsuccessful. Make sure the Beats is turned on and in range. So this is the problem everybody has with Bluetooth, right? It's just finicky as heck. Once these worked, I listened to them like for a while. I walked away. I walked around. I guess I'll put it in pairing mode. Maybe that'll help. And they sounded fine, and they worked fine. They didn't break up until I got more than, say, 50 or 60 feet. I basically had to go in another room far away. But I can't get them to pair again. So the Apple says, we know. So the new AirPods, which come out, when, next month, late October, mm-hmm. will have a new chip in them, the W1 chip. The phone apparently already has the W1 capability. They didn't mention a chip, but the capability. They say it's as on time. We've learned since it is Bluetooth, because they weren't kind of cagey about that, right? It sounded like maybe there's some special new Apple protocol. It is Bluetooth Plus. So Apple's doing some stuff to make the radios better. The pairing with a phone is pretty automatic. You don't have to go through this rigmarole. But you can pair it with other Bluetooth devices, and you will have to go through the standard Bluetooth pairing process. But if you're doing it with an Apple device, the first time you just kind of tap a button, or actually you don't even tap a button, you shake them.
I know there's tapping on the side that's involved.
There's tapping for Siri. Double tap is Siri. There is a pairing button we've learned on the case, the little dental floss case that you put them in to charge them. So that will, and we'll talk, when these come out, we'll get them and we'll talk about it. So that does let you pair with any other Bluetooth device. But when you're pairing with an iPhone, it's quick. And then this is interesting. Apple stores the pairing information in the iCloud, and all of the other Apple devices that are Bluetooth enabled and on the same iCloud account will know already. So you'll walk in the room to your Mac, if the Bluetooth's on your Mac and you're on the same iCloud account, and it'll say, oh, I see you have the AirPods. So that's interesting. Can I give these back? Can I exchange these for?
They'll eventually work. You know what I've noticed? Sometimes you have to be playing something. Have you ever noticed that? I've had Bluetooth headphones not connect unless you were actually playing something.
This is why people were a little upset about losing the headphone jack. It's one thing if there's a good alternative.
Mm-hmm. I have. These are my favorites.
Those are sporty.
These are the Plantronics Backbeat Fit, and
they're pretty.
If you can see them here,
they're for working out. Basically,
yes, they're
right?
They're great with your ear sweat. Sorry, I had to mention that, but they connect.
Your ears actually sweat?
Yep, when I'm running.
No, the ears aren't sweating, but sweat's running off of you into your ear canal.
Okay, yes, that's sweat. So they're harder to lose because they're connected to each other. I have lost them under the couch once, but I found them. You can tap them on the side to turn them on and turn them off. I was showing you charge with a micro USB. You can pause. It'll tell you every time you put them in your ears, it says battery full or battery medium or battery
low. That's nice.
I love it. 8 hours per charge. They're $76. This is an older version. I think the newer version is a little more expensive than that. But $76, not bad. I've had these for about a year, and I've been running. They fold up for easy storage. You can make them very small. And they're nice. And, you know, I haven't done a hearing test. We've talked about my music listening, and you know, I'm not an audiophile, so for audiophiles they might not be great, but for running and listening to podcasts and radio, I think they're great. And the wire cutter also says they are the best of the unsealed. So like if you're talking about Bluetooth headphones for exercise, they're sealed and unsealed. These are unsealed so that if I'm running and a car comes up behind me, I can hear the car.
You want that, right? Yeah. You don't want to be
I mean, unless you just
oblivious.
Run on the track.
Yeah,
you know, so the Backbeat Fit, $79. I have had no trouble pairing them.
Yeah, these are on sale. These were $200, $300 list, and the new replacement Beats Solo headphones with the W1 compatibility are $300.
Yeah,
I don't think I would not recommend these. The problem is no one else is yet making W1 capable.
Right.
Bluetooth, and I think there is, and it will. We hope there will be an advantage to W1.
Yeah. So the Jabra Sport Pulse Special Edition is another one. These are unsealed. So if
let me see if I can pair to these, because I see those on my.
You do? You
yes.
see the Jabra?
Oh yeah.
Pair them.
Just paired. Now I'm furious.
Okay, so I will tell you about the Jabra. I had so much trouble pairing these this morning.
Oh, that's hysterical. It's connected.
And
I could play music through them right
so
now.
That's so funny because I could not get them to pair. And then, you know what? When I put them in my bag and I got in the car and they paired immediately so that I then couldn't pair my iPhone to my car. So, yeah. Bluetooth. It just works.
Let me play
right?
some loud music into your
into my
headphones that I've paired with. It should be coming out of your headphones right now.
I hear it.
Yeah, but it's not. oh, wait a minute. I have to. That's the other thing. Now you have to
I didn't
say.
Know if they're on.
Well, they must be because I saw them and I paired with them. Unless I'm playing this through somebody else's. Kevin, do you have those too?
Who else is here? Maybe someone.
It says it's going through the headphones. It says it's going through the headphones. Oh, I have other headphones. Now, put them on and then they play?
Yeah, maybe.
Okay.
Let me see.
Okay, it says it's playing out of the iPad now. So this is why everybody hates Bluetooth. Can you recommend Bluetooth honestly?
I'm listening.
It's coming through there.
I'm listening to NPR in here. I'll just listen.
Who did I pair with?
That is a really good question. So it says not connected.
No, the Jabra Pulse Smart connected.
Oh, connected, yeah.
No, that's the Beats that I'm not connected to.
That is just bizarre.
All right, let me stop Fleetwood Mac. As much as I love.
Can I tell you a little bit more about the Jabra?
Yes.
Okay, thanks. They're $132, so a little more expensive.
Yikes.
And they also have a heart rate monitor inside of them. And I went for a run today, and it gave me a lot of interesting information. Like, I compared it to the heart rate monitor on my watch. So this was connecting. You've talked before about measuring through ear versus measuring, like, on your wrist. And I was impressed about how similar it was. We've also talked about how what I want for running is voice pacing. Like,
yes.
I want something, because otherwise I'm just
faster,
like,
faster,
yeah, I
slower.
I don't want to have to look at my watch. I want it to say, right, like, you're going under a 9-minute mile, or you're going over a 9-minute mile. Run faster, yeah, run slower. That's what I want. And so that was offering me that in my run. And they fit great. These are sealed, like I said. So the minute a car came up behind me and I didn't hear it, it was super scary. So I wouldn't recommend that.
No.
I think I have a picture on here of what it showed. It gave me a trophy, even though it was only my first run.
Oh, congratulations.
It was my best run. It was my only run. It's also supposed to do my VO2 max.
You see what I'm saying? That's why the AirPods are interesting, because in the long run, this could be a whole new hearables category. Mm-hmm. Instead of the watch measuring your steps and your heart rate and your VO2 max, mm-hmm, you can measure it through your ears more accurately.
Right. It also has all of these different...
You don't have to blow on them or anything, right? You just wear them and it gives you VO2 max.
Yeah, you don't have to blow on them. So depending on how big your ear is or small your ear is, has all these different pieces in here. So you could borrow them and you wouldn't get your earwax on my earwax, which we wouldn't want.
So I'm going to do now what you often, and anybody who's had Bluetooth has been through all of this, you do. You say, okay, well, forget that you ever knew about these headphones. Let's start over.
I restarted my phone to get these to not pair this morning.
It is, I'm sorry. I know there are people in the chat room who say, oh, no, Bluetooth works for me every time. Liars. You're lying. Here we are demoing the clear issue with Bluetooth. I've paired with some stranger's headphones, mm-hmm, but I can't pair with my own darn headphones.
It's going to start measuring your VO2 max. I don't want that.
Exactly why I was very disappointed that the headphone jack was removed from the phone. But I am willing to wait and see, take a wait and see. I think the AirPods might be really great. I mean, if they do pair easily and they work transparently and the sound quality is great. Although I have to point out, they're $160, comparable to those.
Mm-hmm.
And they're not higher fidelity than the cheap EarPods that come in the box with an iPhone today. They're exactly the same. They're the same speakers, same drivers. So you're paying a lot of money for... not the audio quality, but for all the fancy doohickeys. You could pay the same amount of money, get some really nice headphones, and put them in the headphone jack of your existing iPhone and get better audio quality. So I'm not yet a believer.
Yeah, I don't like those. I don't like the AirPods. I don't think they're...
Well, they also look dorky with the little thing dripping out of your ear.
I really find it hard to believe that they would stay in my ears. But people who tested them said that they were okay. We talked to Alex Kantrowitz from BuzzFeed. He ran around the demo room.
I believe nothing that people say from an experience in the demo room. This is why I don't go to the demo room.
But how did they... Do you think they fit them each individually to their ears? Like,
no.
I watched him run around with them.
I understand. Wait till he gets home and gets sweaty ears.
Exactly.
Then
I did ask that question. I ask the hard questions.
Yeah.
I ask about ear sweat.
I think the problem with, and I know this because after many years of going to Apple events, It is a reality distortion field. You go there, you get excited. They're really good marketers. They make you believe what they're saying, and it's exciting. You go in the demo room. You're surrounded by Apple acolytes, by Apple staff. Everybody's smiling. It's kind of like an EST seminar. And then you put the headphones in, and of course, they're incredible. Wait till you get it home in the cold, clear light of day, and then tell me. That's why I kind of insist that we buy these and try them. And we'll buy them, and we'll try them, and we'll give you, you know, a review based on a little more than 1 hour running around a demo area.
Yeah.
By the way, wasn't an hour. I'm sorry.
No,
they don't let you run around for an hour.
I didn't say an hour. I said he just ran. See, there
it
is.
This is the test. That's the test.
There he is. He's running, and he didn't fall out.
Okay, so he ran around for 3 seconds. And Sue from Wired says they're the best headphones I've ever tried. I don't believe any of that until I get them at home and good. It's the size of a quarter.
So the Parrot Zeke are another pair of Bluetooth headphones. I am going to review these on Know How.
Those at least are cool looking.
Yes, you'll have to watch. Jason and I are going to co-host back to school episode of Know How, so you'll have to wait for that.
I admit I'm kind of a headphone buff.
So I
care a lot about audio, and even though I'm an old man and kind of deaf. I've always had good headphones. I wear them professionally, right? Every day of my life I wear headphones. And I care about audio quality. I've spent a lot of money on headphones. I have $1,000 pair of headphones. Am I going to put them into this $9 adapter? To me, this is a mistake. But apparently the market doesn't care because you can't buy these for love or money. They're you're now shipping in November if you order today. Good luck on Friday. Let's all go on Friday.
Yeah, let's go.
All right.
Speaking of spending that much money, it's a good thing that you invest because for the long term for your headphones.
Right, because as you know, one should be saving up long-term investments so that you can buy those really good headphones. And if you're saving up, I took the hint, but it just took it. And walked away with it. That's the problem.
Like, I have to invest?
I didn't actually. our show today brought to you by Wealthfront, which is a really, really clever way for you to do investment for the long haul. And everybody should be at least saving for retirement. Maybe you're saving for college. Wealthfront just introduced their 529 college savings plan, which kind of like a Roth IRA, but for college, for your kids or your grandkids. The problem is you don't want to just take that money and, you know, let it sit there. Because inflation will eat away at it, and you're just going to end up going negative. You've got to invest it. And really, the markets are great if you know what you're doing, but are you going to take the time to know, or are you going to pay somebody to do it? Oh, that's a bad idea. The typical investment advisor will take 1, 2, or even 3% of what you have under their charge every year, plus... Let's face it, they charge you transaction fees, there's hidden charges, and you never really know if they're trading on your behalf or theirs, right? Wealthfront's different. Wealthfront's a computer. So first of all, it's not 1, 2, or 3%. They charge 0.25% a year, 25 basis points, nothing. And unlike a human, they monitor your portfolio constantly, readjusting it, diversifying it, doing things like tax loss harvesting, to maximize your return, minimize your tax bill. It's really cool. The software is based on 200 years of investment experience, some of the best people in the business like Charles Ellis and Burton Malkiel. I mean, really great stuff. And we've got a really good deal for you too, but I don't want you to buy. I really don't. I want you to go there and read. This is an important decision. And I want you to read all about Wealthfront, how it works. Take a look at their performance graph, how they've done in the past. They do have, I got to say, $3 billion in client assets and growing rapidly. So people really like them. I read an article in the Wall Street Journal talking about traditional stock brokerages and how worried they are about Wealthfront. Because Wealthfront isn't expensive and does a better job than they do. Hassle-free investing. You can go to Wealthfront.com/iOS today right now and get a sample portfolio. Just takes a couple of minutes. They'll ask you questions about your time frame, your risk tolerance, all of that, the usual. They do it in a very smart way. They're using some really groundbreaking Nobel Prize winning research to help design a portfolio for you. And by the way, they'll do that for you for free. You can get that portfolio just by going there, answering the questions. And if you want, take it and invest, right? You can also get your current investments and get them to look at those and tell you how diverse they are, how much you're paying in fees and that kind of thing. It's kind of like a checkup for your current investment. All that's free. If you decide, you know what, these guys seem to know what they're talking about. This is pretty good, and they've done really well in the past. It's $500 to get started. That's the minimum investment. After that, you can put a dollar at a time, but $500 to open the account. And then your first $15,000, pretty big chunk, is not 0.25% a year, but free forever. So that's your nest egg. That's your starter right there. And if you're young, you know, and just getting started, this is the time to do that. Put that money in there because you'll be amazed, thanks to the miracle of compounding, how much money you will have and how well Wealthfront works for you. I was just looking at the tax loss harvesting and the explanation there. I don't understand that, but you should if you read it and figure it out. Wealthfront.com/IOS today. One of our few advertisers that I don't actually have an account with because I'm not allowed to. When they started with us, they said, there's only one catch, Leo. If you're going to do the ads, you can't have a Wealthfront account.
I know. They sold it to me, too. And I said, well, that sounds like exactly what I need.
But I have friends who've done it. But many of you have done it and love it. But as soon as they're not advertising, I will open a Wealthfront account. It's kind of weird. I don't usually wish for people to stop advertising, but I do in this case. Wealthfront.
All right. Well, two updates to Instagram. One was about
Finally.
But we haven't done the show. Pinch and Zoom. You can finally pinch and zoom. I don't know what took them so long. I think so. I'll show you.
How many times have you actually pinched Instagram?
I know.
I see Lisa do that all the time, and it never does anything.
Right. Okay. So if you show my screen, I can show you what it looks like. Here's Brian, who's not here doing the show
because he's in Europe.
Yeah. And so I can see what's look at that. Going on there.
Finally. Now it springs right back when you let go, which is
wonderful.
Weird.
But you can also do videos, too.
You can Zoom videos?
Yeah. So here's Jason Howell at TechCrunch.
Oh, yeah. They're playing around with the VR.
And I can even zoom there and see what he's doing. Make sure he's really working.
It is a little weird that it brings back. But I guess it does. Otherwise, you would say, where's my interface? Like,
right.
Where am I? What am I doing?
Exactly. Yeah. So the other...
That's coming to Android eventually.
Yeah.
Not right away.
The other new feature is comment filtering. So this is new.
This just came out today, right?
Yeah. You can... And it doesn't work yet. Well, we'll try it again. Oh. But you can apparently filter out your comments by words. So you can either choose your own words.
So you could say if somebody keeps saying a bad word about you in comments, or... And this is the one I think they put this in for celebrities... Because the minute Lady Gaga or anybody posts an Instagram picture, the feed just fills with people saying, follow me. So I would make hashtag follow me or whatever it is. I would make that be a banned comment. And then you won't see that comment. Mm-hmm. People can leave it, but it won't show up in the comment stream.
So I'll show you how it works on my phone here. Let's hope so. So you could do this little gear icon, and then you scroll down to where it says comments right there. And then it says, sorry, we can't complete your request.
Oh, right,
please try again later. So too many people are doing it. But yeah, you can choose the words or they have a list of words. So you can do that. The other new thing about Instagram is they spoke at the Apple keynote about how you would be able to use the new telephoto lens of your iPhone within the Instagram app.
Oh.
So if I don't usually take pictures within the Instagram app.
No.
I don't know if you do that, but you can, and then you'll be able to just swipe up if you get the new iPhone 7 Plus. You'll be able to use it. And then they're just some of the filters. You'll be able to take advantage of the wide color gamut of the iPhone 7 camera sensor on Instagram. And you will also be able to 3D touch and add things straight to your Instagram story.
I am glad. I'm very glad to see more 3D touch compatible applications because that was a feature. A lot of people just, you know, you didn't know if an app was going to do anything. Now almost everything does it, which is good.
It is nice because that was a problem if you're just, you know, pressing. It's like pinching and zooming when you can't
pinch
and zoom.
Nothing happens. It's very frustrating.
Mm-hmm. Google Photos 2.0 came out with some new features on iOS. Now, we've talked about Motion Stills, the app that lets you take your live photos from your iPhone.
Like one of the first things I'm going to put on my new iPhone.
Motion Stills.
Love Motion Stills.
Well, now, some of the features of Motion Stills is in Google Photos. So you can turn like a series of photos into a movie and then easily share it. So let's open Google Photos here. Google Photos. Let's see.
I still can't. I'm. By the way, this whole time I've been trying to pair these Beats headphones. It's driving me nuts. I swear to God, I spent a whole evening listening.
So I'll take a bunch of these photos I took for Jason Howell's birthday the other day and select those. Let's see. Can I select them? Why won't it let me select them? Oh, maybe I need to go to Assistant and make a movie. Create a movie. Okay, here we go. And I will select all these and then create. And it's going to put all those live photos together into a little movie.
Neat.
For our viewing pleasure.
Oh, that's nice. Wow.
Now, I don't know if this is one of the new features. I don't think that's turning the live photos into... That's a feature that's been around.
Yeah, but if the photos came alive...
Mm-hmm.
So...
They're not coming alive. But that's beautiful, isn't it?
Yeah.
Maybe this is how
wonderful.
I did that there. Anyway, in Google Photos 2.0, you're supposed to be able to make live photos more... and you're supposed to be able to share them and make movies out of them. So do that. And the other new feature that I see that you have, is that your app cap, the Google VR?
No, but I was going to show it. This is good.
You want to show Google's VR cardboard camera?
Cardboard camera. So this came out for Android, of course, because Google did it for Android. But the idea is cardboard, of course, is that Google, really inexpensive cardboard material VR glasses that you hold up like a ViewMaster kind of. So the ability to make photos with this is awesome. So this is a new app free from Google, Cardboard Camera, if you search for that. And you could import pictures. You can take pictures. Shall I take a cardboard?
Sure. I also took one this morning while you were doing triangulation. Didn't you wonder what I was doing in there?
Ah.
That's on my screen if you want to show it. So,
yeah, let's see.
Here it is. It's a 360-degree view of the studio.
Neat. And if you had cardboard and you put your phone... your iPhone in the cardboard visor.
iPad. Yeah.
You can't get the iPad in the cardboard unless you have the monster cardboard. But if you put your iPhone in there, it would look like a normal picture, but when you turned your head, you'd look left and you'd look right. And that's kind of neat, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's like you're really there. So this is, of all the uses of VR, this is the least expensive, and frankly, it gets you like a lot of what you would like. So yeah, that's nice. I'm glad they released a cardboard camera. Hey, guess what? They work. Can you hear me?
I can hear you now.
Anyway, maybe that was a problem. So maybe that was a problem because they were paired to the iPhone.
That is often the problem. That
and then, so maybe if I un... Anyway.
Was the problem I was telling you this morning when my Jabra paired to my iPhone, finally when I was in the car, and then I thought my car Bluetooth wasn't working and I was pressing all the buttons. So, all right, let's move on. Evan Harris sent me a link to 9to5 Mac with an offer to buy 10 movies for $10. To celebrate iTunes' 10th anniversary. So there's many different options. If you scroll down a little, you'll see...
They always have 99-cent movie deals on iTunes, which I often take advantage of, but this is nice. Is it any 10 movies?
No,
or?
No, it's so different studios. So Sony Pictures has these 10 movies for $10. Universal. There wasn't anyone that I wanted all 10 of the movies if you wanted
to... Do you have to buy 10?
It's 10 for $10. Oh. Yeah, you don't have to watch them.
You can buy 9 for $9?
No, it's a
eight
pack.
8 for $8?
No, it's a pack. But they're good movies. They're not old movies. If you click some of those links, you can see what some of the movies are. They're not
most
good.
Good movies are old movies.
Well, they're... It's true. It is true.
Is it? The Monuments Men, not good. Captain Phillips, that was good. You should see that. I'm the captain now. For Who Would Love... To Rome with Love, that's Woody Allen. I don't know. Moneyball, very, very good. Get that. The Social Network, of course. Every geek has to see that. Easy A, not so hot. Although
I loved Easy A.
I love her.
Are you sure you've seen Easy A?
Yeah, I'm not a big fan of high school movies. Julia and Julia, very good.
You should say that before you criticize
Nick and Nora's Intimate Playlist. Yeah, no. Pursuit of Happiness, no. The Da Vinci Code. even with the extended cut, makes no sense. So that's good. I would pay. So the real question is, four movies for $10.
Yeah.
Is it worth it?
Four. Yeah.
That's now, that was just one that. Movie company.
Right. Lionsgate has Mudd. Great film. If you haven't seen it.
About Harvey Mudd?
No, it's Mudd. Two boys help an outlaw, Matthew McConaughey, reunite with the love of his life.
I saw that. That was a terrible movie.
No, it was not.
But he lives in a treehouse or something, right? He lives in the weird...
Ender's Game, also good. A great movie.
Good movie, yeah.
Great Hunger Games.
The Impossible. I don't know that one.
So, yeah, it's essentially...
Arbitrage. Don't know that one.
Yeah.
The Cabin in the Woods. It wasn't calm, but actually, it's a comedy, horror comedy. It's a new genre. You'll laugh, you'll cry, you'll kiss $9.99. Goodbye. The Hunger Games, okay. The Expendables.
You're right, Creamy Corn Cob in the chat room says it needs more Reservoir Dogs. Agreed.
More Reservoir Dogs never hurts.
Mm-hmm.
The Queen was great. Now, we can agree on that.
We can agree on that, yes.
Yeah.
All right, so should we talk about our man bags?
Yeah, I brought all my man bags.
I've got a man bag too.
Now, this all started because this company apparently is a fan, right? Mike, what is the name?
This is Ground.
This is Ground. I never can remember the name. I come up with a lot of names. This is Ground, not one of them.
Mm-hmm.
But they make leather, very expensive. They're not inexpensive, but they're beautifully made. Designed in California, made in Italy. Bags for your gear.
Mm-hmm.
And when he wrote me a note, he said, this is the Mod 3. This is their newest, just coming out now. In fact, I think he gave me his because there was still a receipt for lunch at the Toronto airport in the slot. So, Mike, if you need that, I got it.
He's charging you for that, actually. That's a receipt.
Oh, that was his expense. Okay.
Yeah.
Inspired by, and if you look at this, it'll actually make sense, by the daytimers, the big organizers of the 90s. And I had one. I had a Franklin planner with exactly like this, with a leather thing, and you open it with a zip. But this is for the modern techno geek. And you see, I've kind of populated it, although not fully. A lot of tabs like this for USB cables, that kind of thing. You see, I have pen and pencil, business cards, slots. They've got a little holder for the Apple Pencil. And then what's kind of cool about these is it comes with just those magnetic dots, and then you can buy different inserts for it. So he gave me one, and the reason I know is because I like this so much, I ended up spending a lot of money on his site. This one is kind of designed to hold cables also. This rolls around and holds cables. But I like also this soft backing, because you put your iPad, and this is big enough for a 9.7-inch iPad, the traditional iPad Air or the new small iPad Pro. It also has, you could put your iPhone in here if you wanted to do that. Not that slot, this slot here. And then I have, there's lots of pockets, and it's beautiful, and it folds up beautifully, and it holds all your stuff. But it's not inexpensive. I think this one is it $300? It's
I think so.
The Mod 3 from This Is Yet to Be Determined.
This is Ground.
This is Ground.
And I have the This Is Ground Tech DOP kit.
I really love this idea.
So most of their items come in these different colored leather, like, yours is a slightly different
mine's
color.
Mine's cognac.
I don't know what
yours is. Tan.
Tan. So this fits all your accessories. So it's not really big enough to fit even maybe an iPad mini. It's not even big enough to fit this 9-incher. Maybe if I shoved it in there, but
it's more for wires.
Yeah, it's for all your accessories.
Oh, look at that. Oh, you've got that loaded.
So I've got my Apple Watch bands here. I've got my Bluetooth headphones, two sets of Bluetooth headphones just in case you can't pair one. Your dongle, always got to have a dongle. My business cards, which have the wrong address on them, but I'll still give them out. Because who mails things anymore anyway? And then it has this zipper pocket for other stuff. Maybe you could put your AirPods in here. That's what you would put, or other things.
I put loose change in those.
And then the cord tacos, which I love. This is where I heard about This Is Ground, because the cord tacos...
They're famous.
That's how you keep your cords in line. And I just love... And they have cord tacos with pictures on them. They have different colored cord tacos. This is the craft edition of the cord tacos.
Ooh.
They sell them in a pack. I don't even know what else to put in here. Headphones would be great. Hand me your Beats headphones. I'll see if they fit in here.
Well, they won't fit in there. And if they do, they're yours.
What?
Oh, look, they fit beautifully. They're perfectly. Sort of. You can't
they
zip it up.
Fit, yeah, no, they, yeah, they fit.
Nice.
I'll be going now. Yeah, so this
that's
is around this is $260. $250.
Yeah.
There you go.
Well, okay, so normally I don't accept these, and we'll send them back, and we'll include the Toronto receipt in there so you can get your expenses. But I liked it so much, I kind of went crazy on the site. You know I'm a bag fiend. Mm-hmm. So what do you think of this color?
Oh, you already got it?
Yeah.
Oh.
What do you think of this color? This is their gray, French, I think it's called French gray leather.
I have a pair of boots this color.
Yeah. Yeah, they match my boots too.
Yeah.
You know what I love is this is big enough for a laptop, but then it also, you could put the power brick in there and the wires, and it's got lots of loops.
Nine Apple pencils.
The thing that makes their stuff good is beautiful leather, and that's why these are expensive. This is $800.
He said $800.
$800. Lisa doesn't know I bought it yet.
Now she does.
No, she doesn't. I'm whispering. And then you see it put a laptop. It's got lots of things. And it's just, isn't that soft leather? I love how their stuff smells.
Soft as a baby's
so
bottom.
So then I thought. But wait, there's more. So this is their combat jacket leather, right? And it is kind of like a combat jacket, right? Isn't that nice? And this is just a laptop satchel. They have them in various sizes. This is big enough to hold a 15-inch MacBook. And, you know, just kind of a carrying case. And as with all of their stuff, you can put inserts in these. So you can enhance the capabilities. But I just feel like that's a good-looking little satchel for me to bring to my day job as a Supreme Court justice.
You didn't want to get them all matching? Is that not what you're supposed to do as a man?
No.
Man bags?
I told you I order all the different finishes so you can see them
in
person.
Oh, it's for you.
I do this for you.
Got it.
Cognac, bomber jacket, French gray. Now how much would you pay? Anyway, thank you. These are really, really beautiful.
You know what? Yeah. They're compact, and they don't look like they're going to fit any books. But you know what? You don't need books.
No.
Because
you know what's already on here?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. Toad Sloth in the chat room asks, are you open a menswear store? What's? No, I have a problem.
You have a problem.
I admit it. I have a problem. In fact, I just saw an ad on Facebook for a new man's bag called a nutsack, and I came this close. It's waxed canvas. Please, I beg of you, stop me.
I'll take all the leftovers. I'm not going to stop you because I end up with them when you're not happy.
Yeah.
I mean, when it makes you feel better to give them away.
I can't get in my office anymore. There are so many different bags. But boy, if I have to carry stuff, I'm ready.
Yeah.
Actually, the challenge now is because I am going on vacation. That's why I kind of thought, I should stock up on bags. is what to bring and what to carry, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I was briefly, I thought, I won't bring anything. And then, you know, I won't bring any technology. And then I realized if I don't bring any technology, you know the one thing I would miss? Audible. Because I don't like to get on a plane. If I get on a plane without my headphones and my audiobook, you don't want to be around me. I'd be cranky because I'm not going to watch the movie on the plane. I want to listen to my audiobook, and Audible is amazing. So, of course, I've loaded up my iPhone and my iPad with Audible books. I am ready to listen. Audible is the world's best audiobook store. It's the place to go to shop from literally hundreds of thousands of books, performances, college courses. I always bring a couple of college courses, history lessons about the places I'm going. I like to hear about the history of a place before I go there. You are going to just love Audible.com. We're all big fans of Audible.com. And when you go to Audible, audible.com/iOS today, you can get your first book free. And I think this is smart because, The Girl in the Train is an excellent audiobook. And the movie's coming out, right? Excellent audiobook. Highly recommend that.
Different voices.
There's three different women, right, in the book. You read the book, I'm sure.
I listened to the book.
Yeah. So they have each character has a different reader.
Mm-hmm.
And this is what Audible does so well. It is so much better than if you think, oh, it's just going to be like a mechanical voice reading to me. No, these are all performances by really talented actors who they bring in, and they bring the book to life. Sometimes they even have dramatizations. You know, some of the Star Wars books have dramatizations. But more typically, it's like that, where they have a different voice for the three different women. It makes it easier to understand that which point of view you're hearing. That's kind of how the book is structured. Oh, like Water for Elephants? Phenomenal. You read that. I'm sure you did. Mm-hmm. Classic book. Audible.com/iOS today. Go there right now. You're signing up for the Gold account. That's the book a month subscription. The subscriptions are definitely the way to go because you every month, my renewal day is the 22nd. You can go and you say, oh, I got a new book. It's so exciting. It also saves you money and really saves you money in this case because the first month is free. So pick your book. ADHD Nation. Oh, see that? See, there's nonfiction too, which is good. Children, Doctors, Big Pharma, and the Making of an American Epidemic. See, if you have kids, you got to read this. You got to read this. Fabulous stuff. Every category, all the bestsellers come out on Audible. Audible.com/iOS today. Cancel anytime in the first 30 days. Pay nothing, but those books are yours to keep forever. And you know, I was just going through. I've been an Audible member since the year 2000. And I finally, because of Drobo, one of our sponsors, I bought a giant Drobo drive, like 15 terabytes of storage. So I'm finally downloading my whole library. And you can do that. Every book you've ever listened to on Audible is part of your bookshelf. So I'm downloading all the books because I thought, you know, sometimes there's stuff I haven't read, like I get behind. But there's also stuff I want to reread. With books, mm-hmm. very often you want to reread. Like Ender's Game, I've read 3 or 4 times. Dune, I read a Dune every decade. Lord of the Rings, read every decade. So it's really wonderful to have those audiobooks, just as you would have books on a bookshelf, and have them and available, and you could put them on any device. They have Audible apps. It's just great. Audible.com/iOS today. Get your free book right now. But get ready, because 15 years from now, you'll say, thank you, Leo. I've been an Audible. Literally, I've been 16 years a listener. It's awesome.
Well, we got some questions and feedback, comments. Daniel, a.k.a. Human Chess, writes, I'm seriously on the fence about buying the iPhone 7 because of the lack of a headphone jack.
Yes, yes.
I own several pairs of high-quality headphones. I simply refuse to buy headphones, probably at a premium, just because they have a lightning connector.
Right.
Can you describe the pros cons of devices like the B-Tunes and the Griffin iTrip Clip? I'm concerned about the audio quality and latency. If the iPhone 7 doesn't come with some sort of adapter so that I can use my headphones, I will most likely be switching over to Android. So there is an adapter. Dongle in the box.
Yeah. Well, and he mentioned the one from Griffin. Griffin obviously thought, well, they're going to do this, so we're going to make it possible for people. The problem with wireless, as you saw, is it's not as good. It's not as high fidelity. It has dropout. It has pairing issues. An adapter is probably the best way to go. If you're using wired headphones and you want the best fidelity, you spent money on good fidelity headphones as I have, I'm going to buy the adapter and just hope the adapter is good quality. I'm sure it will be. It's from Apple. And at least they're only charging $9 for it.
So the Griffin iTrip Clip, that turns your wired headphones into Bluetooth headphones.
Right, not crazy about.
Yeah, and that's what the B-Tunes does too. B-Tunes is $99. It was a Kickstarter, and...
See, I'm just not for this. I think that you don't want to make them wireless. You want to get an adapter.
Yeah, there weren't very many reviews, except a couple said the sound quality really suffers.
Inevitably.
Allison Sheridan recommended the Antec Smart Beam. We watched that video. That's a similar thing.
But can I just say, Apple doesn't care about audio quality. Mm-hmm. The fact that they're charging $160 for their AirPods, and it's the same crap audio quality as the headphones they put in the box bothers me. And I don't really think, I think that, you know, when iTunes came out, they made 128 kilobit MP3s. That's how people, or they were AAC, but that's how people bought them. Mm-hmm. I don't think they care about audio quality. So wired is always going to be better. We'll see if the W1 chip makes a difference, as Apple claims. They say it will be better fidelity and easier pairing. If that's the case, then I wouldn't buy those products you mentioned. Wait, use the adapter for your wired headphones. And then if the W1 chip is a great thing, then buy W1 compatible headphones. And it's possible, I don't know how likely it is, that Griffin and other accessory makers will go to Apple and license the W1. Beats is going to make W1 headphones. But if you say you're an audiophile, you probably don't think much of the sound of Beats. Beats is a special sound designed for people who like modern music, and they're like Tupac, and they're not, while they're great for that, I wouldn't say they're hi-fi by any means. They're kind of mid-range, and they're way overpriced. I'm not a fan of Beats. And it's hard for me not to think that Apple is just doing this as kind of a Beats subsidy. It bugs the heck out of me. I'm completely agree with you, Daniel.
So you don't think it's courage? You think it's
No, it's not.
You think it's greed? Maybe
what David Polk, you saw what David Polk said on the new Screensavers on Saturday. I think he made a good case. He said every phone manufacturer would love to take the headphone jack out. That uses a lot of real estate. And the problem in my mind is there isn't a good alternative now. And I don't think, you know, the lightning port is the way to go. So, you know, I'm going to continue to use. I gave up on iPhones a while ago. I'm going to get the new iPhone. Maybe I'll love it so much I won't go back. But I suspect I'll go back to Android phones and their headphone jacks because I like them.
Well, Graham writes, Megan had mentioned on your recent iOS Today podcast that she couldn't find the right long-range electric car. Here's a link that might be some help. There are charging stations all over California and apps at the App Store that you can download to help you locate charging stations. Plug your car in at night in the garage while you sleep. We all collectively need to break the fossil fuel burning habit.
I agree.
To halt the massive damage we continue to inflict on the environment, remember zero emissions is the goal, and hybrids still burn gasoline and emit carbon dioxide.
Well, you got an electric car.
I got a hybrid.
Oh.
Thank you, Graham. Now I feel even guilty.
No, don't feel guilty. We're making great progress.
Just because you can't do everything doesn't mean you should do nothing.
Range is a huge issue.
And it's true. I know about those apps.
I have them all. There's, was it Chargerati and... There's several of them. And of course, the problem is it takes a long time to fill up an electric car. That's why Tesla built the superchargers. Those are pretty fast. You typically would stop for half an hour, no more than an hour, to fill up the whole car and then go on your way. So you stop, have dinner. But with a regular electric car and the chargers you see that are all over the place, you're talking hours and hours to charge them up. They're really useful if you're there for work, or maybe you're there for shopping, or to top it off. But that's the reason people don't buy electric cars is range anxiety. That has to be solved. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I mean, I wish I could have waited for the Bolt. The Bolt is the new one, right?
Bolt comes out later this year. That's from Chevy. B-O-L-T, not V-O-L-T. The Bolt has a gas engine in it, but the Bolt is all electric. And that looks like a good one. And they claim a long range, I think 200 miles. So that'll be interesting to see.
You should get one to test.
I think Lisa might. You know, what's interesting, Lisa still drives a gas car. I got a Tesla, as you know. She, out of kind of conscience, whenever possible, drives the electric car. Because we have solar panels, so we're generating the electricity we're using. And she really prefers to do that. So she has not been driving her Audi very much. And she says when it's time to buy a new car, which it will be, her lease runs out Christmas of next year, so about a year from now, she is getting an electric car. The good news is there's going to be a lot of choices. Volkswagen, Audi, Volkswagen has announced 30 models. There's going to be Mercedes-Benz is going to have a model. There are going to be a lot of choices. So I'm not sure which model she'll get. I'm telling her to look at the Bolt. I think that looks like a very good choice.
The BMW i3, that's the one I wanted. But it didn't fit my whole family.
But range on that is not...
No, the range on that is good.
Is it good?
I don't know what it is, but it's good. And it has a tiny gas tank just in case, too.
That's the reason people buy hybrids or they do this kind of a gas assist. Mm-hmm. Because of range anxiety. They're worried. Because what happens if your electric car runs out of juice? You can't go get a gallon of electricity and bring it back. Mm-hmm. I have to call Tesla to come and charge my car. I don't want to find out, right? You really would be stranded.
Well, Danny writes about how to charge and listen at the same time. Oh. You talked about that earlier without your headphone jack. I've had this Opa Ha 2 for about a year now, and you are able to charge and listen to your phone at the same time while using the DAC amp combo. DAC amp combo.
It's digital audio, digital to analog converter. It's for taking the bits out of your phone and making them analog for headphones.
So it's made for iPhone, and it makes your audio sound great, all while being able to use any pair of headphones.
Oh, I'll have to check that out.
It's $300.
Oppo's a great company. Headphone amps. Audiophiles often use headphone amps. They feel like the amplifiers and maybe even the DACs in smartphones aren't very good. I think Apple actually uses pretty good DACs. And there are some smartphones that are audiophile smartphones that really have good DACs in them. But it's almost always better to use an external headphone amp with a better DAC and a better amplifier. So this, I guess this has a lightning connector that you plug into the iPhone, and it must have another lightning port that you can charge with. But that's going to be expensive.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, $300. But it has a different kind of leather than all the rest of your stuff, so it would fit right in.
A good DAC and a good amp, if you have audiophile headphones, most audiophiles buy headphone amps. It makes a huge difference, especially since many audiophile headphones are high impedance, and that means you have to have extra juice to feed them.
Well, we've already talked a little bit about this, but Stan Cook wrote in to say he sent an email to Tim Cook saying, I'm frustrated. I'm not going to take it anymore, complaining about the loss of the headphone jack.
I bet Tim's getting a few of those.
He got a personal, Stan got a personal email back from Phil Schiller. He said, I'm very sorry to hear that you are unhappy with not having a built-in headphone jack on the iPhone 7. And I wanted to make sure you knew there are solutions for using wired headphones with the iPhone 7. First, we include the lightning to headphone jack in the box with the iPhone 7. And second, our lightning dock includes a headphone jack for using wired headphones and speakers while charging. So that's
Phil Schiller actually typed that. He pressed Command V.
Well, after Stan sent me that, I saw it online. Like, the exact email got sent to a lot of people.
What?
You can believe that.
He must have an electric email writer.
Yeah, offering to pay another $40. And, of course, this was what you talked about, the Belkin Audio Plus Charge Rockstar. But that's not available yet. But it's coming soon. It's a dongle.
The good news is there is choice. There's not choice in the Apple world, but there never has been choice in the Apple world. That's what, Apple is the choice.
Mm-hmm. I like that Lightning dock, though. I almost ordered it, but then the Apple store was all fucked up.
So that has two lightning ports on the back? It lets you
charge
and listen.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. At the same time,
the lightning port is a great port. It's just it's a proprietary port, and to incorporate it into if a company wants to use it and use a made for iPhone or MFI, make an MFI device, it costs them not an inconsiderable amount of money to license. Mm-hmm. And so those things are cost a little. There's an Apple tax. We have a standard that is not proprietary, that everybody supports, everybody uses, every device in the world supports. I feel like they didn't have to take it out. And the argument, by the way, that they needed that room, I didn't really give you the counter argument. I did give it to David Pogue, but that doesn't explain the Note 7, which is a phone with a bigger screen, a pen, and it's smaller physically than the iPhone 7 Plus.
And it catches fire when you charge it.
That's a minor detail. No, you're right. Obviously, I'm not recommending the Note 7 until they fix that. But I'm pointing out, other companies seem to be able to jam all the stuff they want into an even smaller case than Apple. So I'm not sure I buy this that we had to make space for it. Here's what I really think. I think they did plan to take it out next year in this anniversary phone. This anniversary phone, there's a lot of pressure to make something innovative and different. That's why I think Apple's going to finally put in wireless charging. They're probably going to make it ceramic. They're going to use interesting materials. It might be curved, probably will be curved. There'll be all sorts of things that Apple will do that make it very distinct from existing iPhones. If you have a phone with wireless charging, then it makes sense maybe to take out the headphone port and you just use the lightning port because you're charging it wirelessly. You don't have this whole issue. But I think Apple wanted to do the headphone port now because they knew it would get a lot of attention and a lot of complaints, and they didn't want to be the story around the anniversary iPhone. So they're doing this now so that in a year from now, they can do the anniversary iPhone minus a headphone jack, and people won't focus on the headphone jack. I actually believe that's really what's going on. And courage.
And a bunch of greedy courage. In the chat room, Made in New York, with 4 exclamation points, says it has a taptic engine, not a haptic engine. I thought it was taptic too, and I have no idea what the difference between taptic and haptic is.
Taptic is an Apple brand name for haptic.
Okay. You feel strongly about it. I saw 4 exclamation points just coming out of your eyeballs.
It's
Taptic is haptic. Like Band-Aids and
Apple
bandages.
Claims that the haptic engine is somehow magically different from a haptic engine. It's not. It's the same thing. It's a buzzer.
Like the A10 Fusion chip. Fusion.
Yeah, Fusion, W1.
Got it.
Apple, however you feel about Apple, love them or hate them, you got to acknowledge they're the best marketing company in the world. And they're not going to call it a haptic engine if they can call it a taptic engine.
I'm going to call it a saptic engine.
When you start your own company, you can call saptic. It a saptic engine.
And all the people that buy it are saps.
Saps. Somebody's saying, are they going to go plastic or glass for wireless charging? Because as we know, we can't use aluminum. But as I mentioned, I think that ceramic, I think this watch is a test. And I think ceramic might be in the future. There are other materials, exotic materials Apple could use that would allow wireless charging. I suspect it'll be kind of exotic.
Evan wrote in about ceramic, says he has several ceramic watches, as you do. Ceramic is very hard on the Mohs scale. It's extremely difficult to scratch. Takes a diamond or something almost as hard. It's different than the plates that we
eat on. It's not your grandpa's or grandma's little Hummel figurines.
No,
it's
or
not
plates.
Or plates, yeah.
But am I worried about scratching a watch that I'm only going to have for a year? Well, Evan, you can also send me your ceramic watch if you're only planning on having it for a year. I'm happy to take it. As I said, I'm gonna upgrade to the bigger one anyway as soon as Leo decides to buy me one.
You know, the Apple Watch is a mixed bag, as you know, and I think it's safe to say it is not a world-beating innovation. Certainly not on the level of the iPhone or even the iPad. But I think Apple's really trying to make something that's useful and different. And I have a feeling in the long run it will be something really useful or different. But right now, it's just not selling that well. So they're trying stuff, basically. And I think it's interesting to use exotic materials like ceramic. They've doubled the processor speed. They've made the biggest complaint I think most people had about the original Apple Watch was the user interface was so complicated, they've very much stripped it down. They realized that, the little home thing with a little tiny when I saw it the first time I said that's a terrible idea, what are they thinking, and now they've taken that out, so I think they're getting there. We'll see.
Barry wrote in about that squirt gun speaker on the Apple Watch that we talked about earlier, that gets out the water. And he says, leave it to Apple to claim a feature that marine radios have had for years. And he sent me a YouTube video that shows how they work. And I think we have that video. So there's the speaker. Yeah.
Do they go patooey?
Dip it in water and then patooey.
Oh, I want it to. I hope the watch does that.
Yeah, we weren't.
It actually, for those not watching, it that was quite a squirt.
Marine radios.
Yeah.
So that's maybe where they got it from.
Maybe
their marketing is not exactly as exciting
as Apple's.
They didn't
claim that they invented it.
They just
did they?
Put maybe it on they the watch. Did. I don't know.
Apple invents very few things. Mm-hmm. Apple perfects, not invents.
Yep. So I'm hungry.
Well, good news. I happen to have a Blue Apron box with your name written on it.
You do?
I stole it from your porch. Blue Apron is awesome. I love Blue Apron Day. Blue Apron, so the whole idea, the plan, the mission statement of Blue Apron is to make incredible home cooking accessible to everybody while supporting a more sustainable food system and setting the highest standards for ingredients, but most importantly, building a community of home chefs. You may say, well, I don't want to. Who has time to cook? I'm tired at the end of the day. I don't want to shop, meal plan, come home and cook. What if the shopping were handled, the meal planning were handled? All you had to do is come home, open a box of beautiful, delicious ingredients, assemble a meal in less than an hour, and the house fills. And you're making love. You're making something that your family, your loved ones will eat and to nurture and sustain them. It's the best experience ever. I'm telling you, do this once and you will get it. And you will say, I'm in. Blue Apron's nice because they have all, you know, there's everything you need. You never say, and this happens to me every time I cook. Oh, I forgot the salt or whatever. I forgot to get the nutmeg grinder, whatever that you need. Blue Apron comes with everything you need and no more. So there's no waste. If you need a clove of garlic, that's what you get. If you need, 3 tablespoons of sesame oil, that's what you get. So there's no waste. You have exactly the right ingredients. You get a beautiful recipe card with step-by-step instructions and pictures and everything. They make it very easy. And there's even videos online, so you can really become an adept chef. You'll never get the same recipe twice. You'll get unique ingredients, unusual recipes that you will love, that your family will love, because they have a family plan, too, with kid-friendly ingredients. So go to blueapron.com and pick the meals. There's new menus every week. You don't ever have to order a menu you don't like. One of the best things about Blue Apron is they're good for vegetarians. They can handle dietary needs. There's something for everybody. So you pick the menu that you want, three menus, and you'll get the box delivered to you. Actually, we're going to do you one better. If you go to blueapron.com/twit, your first three meals are free. They cost about $10 a meal, which is a lot less. The grocery store costs 60% more. It's a lot less than you would normally pay because they don't have a grocery store. They don't have a brick and mortar. They don't have clerks. They don't have cash registers. They save a lot of money. blueapron.com/twit. You'll enjoy it. Your family will enjoy it. The benefits of it are much more than just a meal, I'm telling you. It's transforming the way we think about eating, and I love it. blueapron.com/twit. First three meals free. Go get it, baby. Why did I turn into a wrestler, you might ask?
That's the question I have. Why did you turn into a wrestler?
Because it's Monday Night Football, mm-hmm. and I'm wearing this to the stadium.
Are you going to the game?
Oh, yeah.
You are?
You think I dress like this for fun?
I thought maybe your app cap was about football or something.
It's kind of like that. But no, I decided that, football season has begun. Thursday was the first game, but this is our home opener for the San Francisco 49ers against the new Los Angeles Rams.
That's awesome.
At Levi's Stadium. And as soon as this show's over, I'm hopping in my Tesla and I'm running as fast as I can to get to the stadium.
And I'm going to apparently go somewhere to dance an Irish jig, perhaps?
No.
No?
That's a Ukrainian.
Oh, I'm going to...
Yeah.
I think you told me that before. I should probably remember.
Yeah, it's cute,
and
isn't
does
it?
This go like this, or does it go jaunty to the side like that?
That much I don't know.
Okay.
I just know it's Eastern European.
Okay.
But you like look myself. Lovely in it.
Thank you. And so we wear caps because cap rhymes with app, and these are some apps that we've been playing with that are our favorites of the week. I will start with mine.
Please do.
And I will ask you a question, Leo. What do you remember as a child of the doctor's office?
Lollipops.
It's safe. what about the Highlights magazine?
Highlights for children.
Highlights
you bet.
For children. Highlights.
Oh, you bet. And somebody had always done all the puzzles with a crayon. It was like...
Well,
it was always like 6 months old.
Yeah.
That's
but times I love have that changed. Magazine. The times have changed. So now they have apps for your iPad.
The Highlights for Children app?
They have lots of apps. And this is my favorite. This is Shapes. So it's free. It had in-app purchases, which I went ahead and purchased.
Oh, look at that Highlights script. Man, that does bring back memories.
Doesn't it bring it all back?
Yeah.
So we'll do some Shapes. No one's done these puzzles. They're all for you, Leo. We're gonna go back to your childhood.
Love that.
It's like a free Highlights magazine.
Don't they have the one with don't be a doobie, doobie a don't be, or whatever that is? You know what I'm talking about?
No, these are just Shapes. Oh. There's many different apps. You can actually get the Highlights magazine on your iPad, but this is a Shapes app. Do you want to go to space, underwater, or the desert here?
Desert.
Okay. Those are the easy ones. So all we do is this.
It's a circle.
A green circle. So it's green for preschoolers.
Circle.
Or yourself.
Space fox.
Yeah. And if you just need to relax a little bit and remind yourself that you know.
Green circle. Green circle.
It's very zen, isn't it?
So this would be for three-year-olds.
Yeah, preschoolers. Preschoolers. Yeah. Green triangle. Learning shapes.
Nice.
And then it gets harder.
It's very sweet, actually. Mm-hmm.
There's a map.
I like the little,
So the space one is a little bit harder. See? Oh, my goodness. Is that a pentagram or?
Pentagon.
Not a pentagram.
It's a pentagram. You know, I wasn't going to say anything, but I think Beetlejuice just showed up. That's nice. You know what? You're very good at this.
I am really good at this. I've learned a lot. Ooh, whoa, this is confusing.
What the? Oh.
Great for preschoolers to occupy them in the doctor's office.
Was that first one a broken heart? I think they should learn about that, too.
Here's the heart.
Oh.
So, like I said, it is free and then in-app purchases, which I think it's totally worth it.
Goofus and Gallant. That was it, but that was in Boy's Life. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
And then there are lots of other apps, and you can get Highlights every day. That's free for 30 days and then $4.99 a month. Do you want to do some more puzzles?
No.
No? You're done?
I think I've learned my shapes, Megan.
You have. Yeah. So great. Back to school, you know, if you're if you have a preschooler or younger.
Very nice.
Or someone's still learning their shapes.
So, okay, I told you I don't have an app cap because it's not an app.
Oh.
It's a web app. And you can play it, actually. It doesn't have to be an iPad or an iPhone, although it really works well on an iPad or iPhone. You can play it on any browser-equipped device, including a desktop computer. In fact, you could play the same game across all the platforms. It's called Overthrown, and it's at overthrown.io. It's free, and it's so cool. So I'm going to log in with Google because it'll then remember. And I'm in Safari.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. And what it is, you can watch the video to get an idea. It's a massively multiplayer online real-time strategy game, turn-based. So there's 50 players in a game. Each turn is a day or a half a day. It's 12 hours. So, and you're going to get an email or a notification when the turn is over and it's your turn to play again. Big chances for alliances, of course, with 50 players on the game board. It's really kind of neat. You'll see there's a lot of games going on. So game 70 is about to start. There's 46 players out of 50. This is the game I'm playing, game 43. And you can see that it's been going on for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 12-hour periods of 3 days. But we'll sign up for a new game so you can, because then you get to see. I'll be Chief Twit. And then, oh, I forgot. We have to wait for more players to play. So we'll go to the existing game. So I got 22 gold from villages, 0 gold from cities. You build it up. If you've played Civilization, Age of Empires, any of these real-time strategy games, you're going to understand this right away. You're going to get what it's all about. But what I love about it is it's turn-based, so it's kind of casual. This is the one negative. It's free. You get a little ad, big deal. And that's the only time you get an ad. Here's my Chief Twitville. I can zoom in on it. Here's other, these are real people, other players. I can chat with them. You can create a chat room. I could take my villager, and if I want, I guess I could go attack. Shall I attack?
Yeah, of
shall
course.
I attack?
Always.
Now, or maybe I should, you know what I should really do is I should build a village. It's always good. I built it one, but I should, the more villages, of course, the more chances you have.
It does take a village, I've heard.
It takes a village. The more chances to make gold. And, of course, you can build villagers. If you've ever played a game like this, you completely know how this works. But I love it that this is web-based. A great game for a mobile device because there's no urgency. You have 12 hours. So you can play this whenever you've got some free time, anytime in the day. You can create alliances. That's one of the best things about this kind of game is, you know, as in Risk, is the ability to team up with people. And you can see it's quite a big game board. There's 50 players in this game. This is a pretty new game. I just discovered this a couple of days ago, and I think this is really kind of cool. It's called Overthrown, and it's at overthrown.io. So it's not specifically iPad or iPhone. It can be anything you want. As long as you've got a browser, you can play it. And I think for free, as a casual game, I love this style of gaming. This is a lot of fun.
So if you started it on your Note 7 and then it blew up and you got an iPhone instead,
see?
It'd be great for
exactly.
you.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Exactly. How's that mask doing?
Wrestlers, how do they keep from itching?
Don't ever give me that mask. I never want to wear that mask. Please.
No, it's mine now, baby. Wow, this has been a lot of fun playing iOS today with
you. We did it again.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We do this show every Monday right after a triangulation. It's usually about 1:30 Pacific, 4:30 Eastern, 20:30 UTC. Sometimes earlier, sometimes later. Of course, we have to finish by 4 because that's when Tech News Today appears mm-hmm. with Megan Maroney and Jason Hell. In fact, you got half an hour to get ready for your big shoe.
Yes. And of course, next week you will not be here.
Who's going to fill in for me?
Georgia Dow.
Oh, that's awesome.
Is
going to
fill in next week. And then the week after that, Mike Hurley
from Relay FM. He's great too.
Yes. And Andy Anatko is going to fill in for the third week.
Wow. I'm going to be gone that long.
You are. You're not missing all your shows that long, but you are missing 3, or maybe you just have given up on me.
No. I can't. I'm going to miss this show. I'm going to be sad, but I will bring the new iPhone, and okay. I'll be sending pictures back. In fact, I'm going to send you postcards because I'm going to use Bill Atkinson's photo card, one of my app caps from previous, and I'm going to send physical photos to you. In fact, I've pledged to several people to do one every single day. So look for my postcards. Unfortunately, they'll just start arriving right about when I get home and continue for weeks after. But that's just life in the big city. I'm mm-hmm. looking forward to that.
Well, we look forward to your social media because you are bringing technology.
Well, I had to bring Audible. And then so once I thought, oh, I brought up. And then the iPhone came out. I thought, well, I really should bring the new iPhone. I can take pictures with that new camera. And then, you know, the ceramic Apple Watch. And then, well, by that time, I might as well bring everything I have. Mm-hmm. So fortunately, I have lots of bags.
Oh,
to put
your
them
This
in.
Is Ground bag. Shh, Lisa's over there. Don't tell her.
Thanks for joining us. We'll see you next time on iOS Today. Now I'm supposed to peel this off and throw it.